clearly I'm not having all that much luck finding these guys I've heard so much about. But I did run into my old friend Suzanne Westenhoefer, so maybe I'll go see what she has to say about this.
No, every woman in this room knows this, and you know this. This is horrible. Because the first thing you think is, oh my God, I'm single, oh my God, quack, cry, cry, cry. And then the second thing you think is, oh fuck. Now I have to let someone new see me naked.
Hey, so I'm still here at the Dinah, and luckily
still here? Like, it's the worst thing that ever happened to you?
No, but I'm here because the running joke is that I'm writing The Idiot's Guide to Meeting Gay Men, and I came down to Palm Springs to meet gay men, and it's the Dinah. So that's
honey, they are all hiding at the Starbucks in the city over. That's all I'm telling you. When are the lesbians leaving?
The boys have cleared out.
You'll find them, though. They're all hiding in one spot.
As you can see, I am here with Suzanne Westenhoefer, who is just been so gracious to sit down and talk with us today after her...
In her fabulous suite.
And after her just knocked down hysterical show last night. Congratulations.
Thank you.
It was hilarious. And
fun.
I had a great time. And I think as we mentioned, you know, our cameras were shaking because we were on these crazy platforms laughing so hard.
If I can get the camera to shake with laughter...
You have done your job.
I've done my job.
Well, congratulations. And, of course...
It was my birthday.
Happy birthday. That's fantastic.
I did a show at the Dinah on my birthday.
That's amazing.
I know. It's like having this huge party just for me.
Right.
And I got a tiara to wear afterwards and cupcakes. Cupcakes with little chocolate pretzels on the top. You know, chocolate-covered pretzels right on top of them.
That sounds like my kind of cupcake.
Whoa.
Well, happy birthday.
Thanks.
And so, you know, we're here at the Dinah weekend, and we keep making this joke, but what is it that brings you back? Because this isn't your first time here at the Dinah. Why do you keep coming there? You can do anything you want, and
well,
you come
back. Well, I get
hired. But why do you agree to come back?
I'm a lesbian comedian. This is the ultimate one.
Right.
All year. Of all the shows that you're going to do. I mean, there's Women's Week in Provincetown, and there's Women's Week in Key West, and those were both genius. And there's Aqua Girl in Florida, and there's the Michigan Women's Festival, and there's a lot of great events to do. But the Dinah is the one I can drive to.
Period.
And just saying. And I don't have to get on a plane to come to the Dinah.
And how many years have you been coming to the Dinah?
You know, we've been trying to figure that out. And I think that, because Mariah, who runs the Dinah, is a very good friend of mine, actually. I think my first year was 94.
Wow.
And I think I missed, since then, I've probably missed like 6 years. So whatever that is.
What's been the big sort of difference from when you started?
There used to be golfers here.
There are no more golfers.
There are no more golfers. And there aren't even chicks who look like golfers anymore. I don't know where they've gone. I haven't seen a pair of khaki shorts, and I've been here for 48 hours.
How about visors?
No. I haven't seen a visor, khaki shorts, nothing.
And nary a golf club.
Not a golf club, not a golf ball.
You know, there's just girls from all over.
The world.
And what is it about this particular event? Like you mentioned some of the other ones, like in Key West and
there's a lot of great events, yeah.
And why this one? Why are they coming here?
I think the Dinah, the reputation here for sex and debauchery and fun and drinking and it not being frowned upon and it being encouraged and a kind of fun around that, you know, I think that's part of it. And then the second thing is consistently, Mariah brings the best freaking entertainment. My God, she had the Pussycat Dolls, she has Kesha, she had Lady Gaga, she had Katy Perry, me, Paula Poundstone. I mean, she brings the best entertainers. So it's not just all the fun, frolicking, pool, sex, crazy, and that's all sort of encouraged and not looked down upon. You know what I mean? It's kind of like, it's fun, let's just do it, take your top off, it's, you know, whatever. There's the fact that, my God, there's like the best entertainment. So
that's amazing.
I think that's part of it. I really do. You get a lot of bang for your buck when you come here.
And do you ever play for, I mean, this is like, you know, we were in the audience, as I said last night, and it was just a sea of women, which must be really a trip unto itself. Do you ever play for predominantly male audiences as well?
Yes, I do. And it really depends on where they advertise, what the event is. Like, and obviously I've also performed on all gay boy cruises. And that's 2,500 fags on a ship, honey.
I can't for the life of me imagine.
And
what that's
I have to get up there and do a 75-minute show without mentioning Judy Garland. You have no idea how hard that is.
Is that in your, is that a contract?
Well, no, it's just that every other fag has already been just dressed like her. They're walking around like her. They're playing the music. I can't talk about Barbara Streisand. I mean, like, it's been done, you know? I've got to really reach for my comedy is what I'm saying.
And what do you find is the greatest difference between playing for mostly, is that it, that you can talk, you can say to women?
No, the biggest difference between playing for an all-gay girl and an all-gay boy audience is I'm a lesbian and I love lesbians more than anything else, but gay boys will laugh at the meanest, darkest humor, where lesbians will laugh, but then they feel bad about themselves. And I go dark. Last night, what was the main topic? Cancer, cheating.
Unbelievable.
And the audience is howling. But so I go to dark places. And one of the things about lesbians is that you have to take them there a little more gently.
Mm-hmm.
With gay guys, you can get right out there and tell the joke about the dead baby, and they are just crying, laughing straight up.
Well, I have to say, I mean, I've seen you perform before, and last night's set, I thought, had a really particular edge.
Had a little edge, had a little darkness.
It did, and I loved it.
But it worked, right?
Yeah, it was
fantastic.
And
you probably loved it even more because you're a fag.
I think so.
Although I got a lot of lesbians who were coming up afterwards who have cancer, mm-hmm. or suffering from cancer or whatever, and they were loving that I was mocking out the whole way people treat people with cancer.
Absolutely.
Like that. Really great. I felt kind of charged by that because, like, you never know. It's either lesbians either approve or they write a letter to Curve magazine and bitch about it. You know what I mean?
Well, do you think there's ever going to be a point where you can have because next week is the white party here in Palm Springs.
But that's boys.
Which is boys. But do you ever think there'll be like a place where there'll be the white party and the Dinah together? Not necessarily those two particular events, but like the guys and girls.
Isn't that pride?
Is it?
Yeah.
Your joke about pride. I'm the person who's like, oh, is it pride again
this
year?
Pride again?
So
I think that's pride.
It is?
You know, I think that is.
Is that what the kids are doing now?
I think that's what they're doing. They're going to the parade, like boys and girls are going to the parade together.
Wow.
Maybe. You know, they're having both male and female entertainers at the rally.
But do like girls go to like the pier? I'm New York centric, so would they go to the pier dance?
I mean, I went to the pier for years.
All right.
I probably saw you there.
I'm sure you did. I think
In fact, I remember. Okay,
please,
nothing,
I am notorious for cruising girls. Like, I'm like, God, that guy's really cute, and it's just this really butch.
No gay guys ever think I'm a gay guy.
What was the first thing I said last night? I was like, Suzanne Westenhoefer looks hot. We're here at the Dinah. What happens next now? Where do you go?
I'm here for the weekend. I have a whole lot of events to do, and then I go to San Francisco.
Oh, fantastic.
Two shows at the Victoria Theater, and then I go to Ephrata, Pennsylvania, which is a small town in Lancaster County, outside Philadelphia, which is great because my whole family is from there, still lives there. So, like, not only will my family be able to come, but, like, the last guy I slept with, my babysitter from when I was 5, you know, cousins, like, everyone will be able to come to the show. So it'd be, like, it's like a family show. It's fun.
Fantastic. One last question, because I know you've got a lot to do. Do you ever look back at your life and you're like, you were talking about how much you love being on stage and
how I do.
Do you ever think like, holy cow, how the hell did this happen in my life?
Every fucking day. Can I say fucking?
You can.
Because I thought I was going to be a famous movie star. And now instead I'm some sort of pioneer lesbian comedian. it was not where, I guess I'm still performing. So yes, I think about it all the time.
Well,
how did this happen? But thank God it did. I'm loving it.
Well, thank God it happened, and we're so unbelievably appreciative of everything you've done.
Thank you, honey.
Thank you for sitting
down.
I'm so
glad you guys came to the show last night. I want to say that on camera. Like, a lot of people, journalists and stuff, who come to interview me, they don't even come to the show the night before, but then they come and talk to you, and it's like, you guys came, and you laughed, and you were part of it.
Loved. I can call you Susan, then, right?
No. Because it's Suzanne.
Well, thank you so much, and absolutely congratulations,
have fun while
and
you guys
happy
are here.
Birthday. We
and
will.
Yeah, happy birthday. Thank you.